Hello everyone and welcome back to Eve Market. Your weekly look at the Amman market. It's been 2 weeks ago. I thought 2 weeks ago I was not sure if I could bring out last week. I did not got the time for it. I'm getting a little bit quiet time now. Gonna be still away next Saturday whole day. But I should be fine to bring it out on Sunday. So yeah, it's been 2 weeks, so maybe a lot of changes, maybe not. So just gonna look at the market and see what all the minerals has done and a few of the salvage. So let's start off with titanium. Titanium has been 2 weeks, so a little bit in the middle of the graph. It still went up then. It has gone down, but after that it went up. And at the moment it's still going down. We are sitting in the Sunday. I had to check because I was not sure. So the last 2 days I cannot say what it's gonna do. It has a very low point here, but I cannot say this is why, because there's hardly anything sold today. But the days before that it definitely went down. 5 and 20 days average went down. So I think we had I think we definitely had the highest prices here from titanium, and now starting to drop. Prices for titanium, and let me turn on the filters again. For the sellers, we're sitting at 6 ISK. For the buyers, and let me send my tune away. And for the buyers, we're sitting at 5.94. That's exactly the same price as 2 weeks ago even. So no changes in that at all. So that's an easy one. Still, there are pretty lot of orders up. Pretty decent size. Well, 100 million is not a lot. 142 is not a lot. 250 is already a good size. This one is a good size. This is definitely a good size order. But overall, not any crazy amounts. So let's go on for the next one. That's ferrite. Let's see what ferrite has done in these 2 weeks' time. It hasn't done a lot. Not looking at the last twos. And overall, in these 2 weeks' time, ferrite has been dropping in price. 5 and 20 days has been dropped. It had at the end of about 7-8 days, it did went up. But after that, it has dropped again in price. And it seems to be starting to more stabilize here around just below the 1160, 1155, it looks like. So that's, it looks like it's stabilizing around there, but it's never really stable. Prices for ferrite for the sellers in 11.50. And for the buyers in 11.46. That went definitely a little bit down since 2 weeks ago. 11.81 was the price 2 weeks ago. So it has been dropping in price again. It seems to be keep on going this for a while. And holy crap, this jet here. And we're just gonna say block you. There we go. Jesus. So it has been going down for like for easily a month now. And it seems to be keep on going with usually a little bit of ups. Then the price drops again and then again up. I'm getting a bit tired, but late at night here. So definitely a little bit of a drop in there. Next one is Maxelon, and I forgot to put out the pallet on my other account. So we're just gonna keep on flying manual on that one. Okay, Maxelon. Also, this one is already going down for like a month. It drops a bit, then it climbs a little bit up, and then it has another drop, and keeps on going. And overall, Maxelon is dropping in price. So it drops in about 3 weeks' time with 2 ISK, of 1 ISK per unit drops in like 2-3 weeks' times. More like 3 weeks. So it's not a quick drop, it's slowly dropping. And yeah, that's fine, of course. Lower prices, lower production costs. So let's see what the prices are. Sellers prices 47.31. And for the buyers in 46.71. 2 weeks ago, 47.45. So it has dropped a bit, about a half an isk. Not a huge amount, it has dropped, but it's a stable drop that Maxilon is doing and keeps on going on for it. So that's pretty nice if it keeps on going like this. Alright, next one is gonna be Isogen. Let's see what the Isogen is doing in these weeks. Also, Isogen already for a whole month it is dropping in price with this. Basically the same view as all the other minerals we have seen now. It drops, crawls a little bit back up, and it drops again. That's what it seems to be doing here. Only a little bit less than the rest of the minerals that we have seen. But it definitely is doing the same thing, and it keeps on dropping. It is what drops. Well, 2 isks per 2 weeks, it looks like. What it's doing. So, it's a pretty drop for Isogen. Definitely, what it's currently doing. Seller price, 124.23. And the buyer's price, 115.29. That's definitely a good drop for almost 10 isks per unit in this 2 weeks time. 2 weeks ago, 125.22. So Isogen is definitely on the drop. And I think I need to buy some in. Oh, I hit my mic. So, it's a big drop for it. Almost 10 is drop for Isogen in 2 weeks times. Alright, next one. Noxium. Alright, one more Noxium. Here it is. Wow. We know 2 weeks ago it was dropping, and as we see now, it's still dropping. It hasn't stopped it, and it's going down a lot. It looks like it even dropped below the signed price, but we'll come that to a little bit later, after this one even, at the signed price, but signed was also dropping, so maybe. But Noxium is definitely dropping, and a pretty steep drop too. If I look at my 2 weeks times, it has dropped from about 7, just above the 700, to just what, 655, higher, on the middle. But it's dropping hard, Noxium, definitely. So let's quickly look at some prices for it. Seller's price is 676.76. And a buyer's price 648.59. 2 weeks ago it was sitting at 700. So there's about a 51.5 drop in price. For Noxium. So it's a good drop. It's finally dropping even. I think definitely it was about time that Noxium started dropping. Was Zynut was already for a long time. The price was lower than Noxium. Well, it should be the other way around. And it looks like it's changing now. But we're gonna see what Zynut is doing right now. Zynut is still standing pretty low, but it looks like it hit its bottom point. Because you see it's definitely slowing down in dropping. And I guess it's gonna spike up. Maybe not spiking up, but the price will increase in Zynoid, definitely. It's gonna be probably happening this week or maybe next week, but this price is not gonna hold long. Just above the 630. Zynoid is not gonna hold that, definitely not. So the prices for Zynoid are 640.80 for the sellers, and that's over 1.4 million units even. That's a big one. And then buyer's price, $628.15. It's still lower than Oxygen, but it's not much anymore. But I think this is gonna change soon. That Cyan is gonna be more expensive than Oxygen. Definitely. Signed with 2 weeks ago, $637.77 was the price 2 weeks ago, so it still has dropped a bit. Almost 10 isk per unit. But it's not dropping so hard anymore, and expecting it's definitely gonna go up in the next 2 weeks. That's what I'm definitely gonna expect for a Zynrid. Then Megasite is also on the drop, but for the last 2 days, it's just today and yesterday. Those are not counting in here yet. But at least a day before that, that was Friday, the price is higher than 4 days before that even. So it looks like Megasite hit its bottom point on price. And it's probably starting to recover. I don't know if I can get anything about this table. No, I cannot get anything out of it. On the average price. On the average price, it's in the same here. Because it didn't change it. So I cannot see it. But I guess, definitely think that Megasite hit its bottom point and starting to go up too. Just like Zynrid. It will start going up soon, within 2 weeks. Definitely. So prices for Megasite. And, I said it's gonna go up, but if I look at this, not that many buyers. So I'm not even sure if this is gonna go up in price. Unless there are a lot of people thinking, oh, buy now, of course. What probably is gonna happen, what's gonna push the price up. Definitely. So, prices for the sellers, $1,461.95, which is only 176 units. The top one, I'm not gonna do that one. That's the seller's price. For the buyers, $1,375.56. 2 weeks ago, $1,403 for Megasite. So it's definitely a drop. And it's not gonna drop more. It's not gonna drop more this price because the decent size orders up. And I definitely think, let's see, additional orders. Let's see, that's high sec. These two, I'm not even sure. But yeah, there are not many orders up. I definitely think it's gonna go up soon in price because it's low now and people are gonna buy in Megasite now. Definitely. One more mineral, Morphite. It's not doing so crazy anymore as before. There's really big spikes up and down. It seems to be a little bit more on a stable line. But on average, it started like a month ago, but 2 weeks ago, it definitely started to drop a little bit more, and now it's keep on going this drop. You see even points here that's just above the 6,000 for Morphite. That's very, very low. But on average, we're starting to see a little bit more flatter line around the 6,600. But I think this is, I think Morphite is going to keep on dropping for now. There has been a large amount of me sold. Probably straight to sellers or buyers. Probably to buyers, and then this keeps on getting these very low points here. What's gonna happen? So prices for Morphite. $6,549.95 for the sellers. For the buyers, we're sitting just above the 6,000. 6,111. 2 weeks ago, 6,450. So it has dropped a pretty decent amount for Morphite. It's gonna keep on dropping. If you look at the sellers, there's pretty big amounts up here. There's a bigger supply currently than demand on Morphite, so that is definitely gonna keep on pushing this price down, definitely. Alright, let's look at a few salvage here. Armor plates still going down in price. It is stabilizing now and then, sitting at the same line. Then it drops again, sitting at the same price for 2 weeks. Dropped again, went a little bit up. Pretty stable there. Then it dropped again, pretty stable. And for today it dropped again, but it's early day. So, on average, armor plates is definitely dropping in price, because it's already so incredibly high. And it looks like it keep on going. So, seller's price, 143,000, just above it, for the armor plates, and for the buyer's price, 141,250. And here I'm doing some wrong, because I said always above the 500 units. So that's 146,969. That's the price. 2 weeks ago, armor plates were saying 151,100. Saying now 141,250, so that's about almost 10,000 drop in price per unit. And that's a big drop for armor plates, but armor plates can use it, definitely, because it has been so high, this price, for ages. And now it's finally dropping again. It looks like it's gonna keep on going for a while, this price dropping, and not gonna stop for a while. That's what I'm thinking. Burn logic circuits. They're going up in price. Exactly since about 2 weeks ago, it's starting to go up in price. It had a spike before, then it dropped and is crawling back up again. A lot slower than before that. And for the last day, 2 days ago, it has gone down a bit, so looks like it's starting to go down again. So it has its up and downs burn logic circuit for the prices. Seller's price, 35,443, more like 44. For the buyers, 32,763. That went down since 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks ago, 36,194.50. So that's almost a 4,000 drop for burn logic circuits. That's a decent drop, definitely. For now, both salvage armor plates and burn logic circuits has dropped in price, so that's something saying, maybe. Because all the wicks are getting cheaper then. Alright, fried interface circuits. Let's see what these are doing. Holy crap, what happened here? Wow. I did not expect this one here. They were sitting like for 2 weeks time, flat on the 5,000. And then suddenly it dropped like a stone. More like a concrete wall or something. Not even a stone. It just dropped just above the 4,000. That's a huge drop for burn logic for fried interface circuits. It's really, really huge. It's maybe a 1,000 drop, but that's big. After that, it's starting slowly crawling up the price again. And it's crawling back up to 4,600, it looks like it. And I think this is gonna recover soon again towards the normal price around the 5,000. Someone just managed to crash the market. There's not even an a strange amount of huge sales around this point. It just dropped like a concrete block or something. Amazing what here happened. It's not even a market question, it just dropped. Seller's price 4,800, just one is below that. For the fried interface circuits, and for the buyers, we're sitting at 4,600 flat even. Well, the next one is sitting even 4,301. 2 weeks ago, we're sitting even lower than that. We're sitting at the 4,000 mark for the fried interface circuits. So the buyer's price went even up since 2 weeks ago, and that went up at 600. So that was a surprise. Well, yeah, it could be alright, because the graph says, I think that's about 2 weeks ago, yeah. Yeah, that's about here when the price dropped. Really dropped like a stone. Alright. Next one, melted capacitor consoles. It has been slowly dropping for like two and a half weeks. Yeah, 2 weeks. After that, about a few days ago, it started to go up again in price. Then it dropped again a little bit. It doesn't have a really stable spot. But it's moving around a bit. The highest point was even above the 5,500. 5,650 around, I guess. After that it dropped again. 2 days ago we're sitting at 4,500. Nah, 750 around. 4,750 around here. So it's not like huge movements around, it is moving. Seller's price 5,995, just below that. And for the buyer's price in the 4,750. Still, it went down since 2 weeks ago. 5,050 was the price 2 weeks ago. So it went down with about 300 ISK per unit. And that's not a bad drop for melted capacitor consoles to have. We got one more for you. It's the last one, trip power circuits. See, 2 weeks ago it was basically going up in price again. It kept on going for that until about 5 days ago. That was setting a very high point. That was 6 days ago even. A very high point. And the fifth day it suddenly dropped to about 64,000. And it kept on going, dropping towards about the 62,000. Low price for trip power circuits. This looks like it's gonna keep on. Maybe. No, this is low point now. This is lowest price I get now. If you look at the graph, it goes up, goes down, sit around that price, goes up, goes down, a little bit around the price, goes up, goes down. So we're staying around this price again, and within a few days it will start going up again, the price. So you need it, buy it now, I say. Definitely do that. Seller's price 64,989. And then the buyer's price is 62,063, just above it. Slightly lower than 2 weeks ago. 63,300 was the price 2 weeks ago. So that's a slight drop in that. Still, yeah, buy it if you need it. Yeah, do it, because this price is gonna go up again in like a few days, 2 to 3 days. I guess the price is gonna go up again. If you can clearly see it on the graph, what's it gonna do? Alright, that was this week's look at the Yamaha market. Next week we'll be back again to see what all the prices are doing. And we'll see you all then again. Fly safe.